We have contrast in the tail of the tape. 4 years difference, Breland the champion, that much younger. Look at the height difference. Wow. And then the weight is the same. 1 pound under the welterweight limit of 147. Mark Breland noted at that 6 foot, 2.5 inch frame for a long reach, 77.5. They have never met before. Remember, Marlon Starling at Homer looking from Hartford, Connecticut. 4 losses. He has never been knocked out. He has never been knocked down in his lengthy career, which began in 1979. There is Breland. Golden Glove, national, world amateur, Olympic champion who has parlayed that gold into a world championship. Is welcome in Colombia.
Tony Perez will now give the boxers their instructions.
Very competent referee, Tony Perez, will handle those chores. The three judges, Harry Caccini of Maryland, Carol Polis of Pennsylvania, Edward Levine of Florida. Perez sends them back to their corner, along with their seconds, their trainers, their entourage, and in this 20 by 20 ring, we're ready for only the second fight ever in the capital city of Columbia, South Carolina. There's Grandma Breland. That's right, watching her grandson in his 19th professional fight. Here we go.
Starling told us he's going to be very aggressive, try to keep Mark Breland off balance, not let him get set, not let him get into his rhythm. Mark said he was going to try to work everything off the jab that he's been developing. There you see it there. Don't forget that when Mark won the title in February, he broke his left hand, and it required surgery. Since then, he's had only one fight, a 10-round non-title fight, over a mediocre opponent last month. He didn't baby the left in that fight, Chris, and he said there was no pain or swelling. It would be interesting to see if he throws it with power against Marlon Starling.
Starling with those 8-ounce gloves up alongside his face. Good defensive weapon, and there he tried to land the punch and duck inside and then tie up the much taller champion.
And trying to use his strength against Breland. He thinks that he's stronger than Mark. And he thinks that he can get inside and rough him up there. He said Marlon told us yesterday, if Breland tries to clinch with me on the inside, I'm going to throw him out of the ring. Well, he threw him to canvas that time.
Okay, a lot of timber there, 6'2.5". And Starling believes that the champion is a clumsy welterweight. Well, we haven't seen Breland too clumsy over all the fights that we have watched him compete in. Tony Perez, the referee, taking a look at the face of Starling. We're checking now. There is no cut or anything, but Perez is looking very closely at the face of Starling in the red trunk.
Marlon Starling called Mark Breland clumsy. I think he was overstating the case, but Mark does have a balance problem that he's worked very hard on. When he's on balance, he's very effective. But if you can rush at him, get him off balance, make him tend it.
There was a stiff left jab that just caught Breland's chin. And Breland comes back with a solid right hand to the side of face.
Oh, good left by Starling. Breland holds on.
Starling said he would faint a lot. He's not, to this point, not juking at all. He's coming right at the champion.
Calling Breland's a matter of, Chris, we talked at the top about the question of Mark's left hand. There are other questions about Mark which may be answered in this fight, namely his chin and his stamina. He's only been 10 rounds twice, and he's never been past 10. Breland's already proven his staying power. As you said, he's never been down as a pro.
And he's fought Donald Curry 2 times. Once shot at the title and lost a 15-round decision.
Good uppercut by Mark on the inside there, Chris.
Mark is just... Not that he's cautious, he's being patient. This is the first round, if you just joined us, about the 10 seconds till the bell. Scheduled for 15. 10-point must, 3 judges, the referee does not do the scoring. They'll get a rest in about 3 seconds.
All right, second! Hold it.
We're back in Columbia, South Carolina for the first defense by Mark Breland of his 147-pound world championship title. All right, he's on the left in the blue trunks, probing round for Mark. More aggressive, coming from the challenger, the number one contender in all organizations, Marlon Starling, in the red trunks. Very veteran, tough opponent.
Just saw Marlon do what you talked about the first. Oh! Mark almost walked into that right hand. It just missed. Marlon was trying some of that juking, some of that feinting that he hopes will get Mark Breland off balance. Mark didn't take any of the feint. He did, however, leave himself open when he came in, and Starling countered well.
Either throw the punch coming in or keep the duke up, the left hand. He dropped it, which is one of his habits. He'll drop his hands about waist high from time to time.
You're talking about Mark Breland.
Breland.
Yeah. Mark is not in trouble. trouble, Chris, I don't think from Lee. He gets in trouble after he punches. He leaves himself open. He
right there.
He has to concentrate on jabbing and moving out of, not just jabbing, punching and then moving out of range.
He has a punishing jab, Breland. It's not only long, but it's stinging, and it'll keep a fighter off balance. He's going to have to use it a lot against Marlon Starling.
Ooh, a 1-2. Exactly. That jab can be a good defensive weapon as well, Chris. Keep his man worried about it, not throwing his punches.
Breland out from his arsenal. A right-hand lead that caught Starling. We're in the second round. Remember, Starling has never been down. Hook to the body thrown by Starling.
You see Mark's left down by his weight. He's now waiting for Starling to come to him. Mark Breland says he likes a fighter who comes to him. But I think that fighter has to come in under control. When he comes in wildly, it gives Mark a lot of trouble. He doesn't know how to line him up. Good right hand to the body by Breland.
He is putting shots to the body. Another one to the opposite side by Breland. Shoving him off, showing he has strength too.
Right now, Marlon Starling is in no man's land. He's too close. He's close enough to get hit, but not close enough to land his own punches. He has to lunge in with right hands like that that Breland got out of the way of.
Alex, he saw the opportunity with that left hand down. And champion Breland beginning to weave a little more. Not necessarily bob and weave, but weaving just a bit. A little bit of a moving target, and it's a good idea. As Starling moves, he's hard to hit. And he's laughing, as a matter of fact, but that combination missed. Not that right uppercut. They'll get a rest in a few seconds. This is a world championship bout. Welterweight, WBA, third round, scheduled for 15. The champion, Breland in blue, much taller. Marlon Starling throws him to the deck. One more time, and now gets up. Strong caution from the referee, Tony Perez. Second time in this bout. In the corner, Breland's Joey Ferriello, the trainer, told him not to go happy with the left-right combination. Double up on the jab.
Good right hand by Starling. Marlon is not a big puncher, but he's a strong, accurate, sharp puncher. And of course, Chris, any time a potentially great fighter like Breland comes along, you want to see what happens when he gets cracked on the chin.
Yeah. Starting with 25 knockouts.
Oh, again the right hand.
Bunker for the right hand in this fight, the champion.
Chris, it's little habits like carrying your left too low that don't show up against lesser opposition, but when you move up to a Marlon Starling, he's going to take advantage of that.
You saw Breland miss with a right uppercut. It's a punch that he wants to find the range for, because with a covering up opponent like Marlon Starling, it will work. See, that left is a defensive weapon as well as an offense. Breland in the past has either been tight or loose. We think he is in between. He's not as loose as we have seen him. Not as fluid.
A lot of that has to do with the pressure that's being put on by Starling. Right there, you saw Mark with four or five punches get Starling's respect.
Yeah, but look at Starling pick off the punches. What a defense. That's below the belt. That one did not land. And he's laughing at Breland. Well, I wouldn't do that if I were Starling.
You're right that he did pick off a lot of the punches. That's one of the problems with scoring a Starling fight. He carries those hands up there like earmuffs, and you really have to watch which ones are landing on Marlon Starling and which ones are landing on his gloves. But Mark Breland did get home with punches in that flurry and made Starling stop.
Not the first welterweight that has found Starling's style confusing, believe me.
But he's done something here in round three, Chris, which was essential. I think he's gotten Starling's respect. He's cracked him a few times, and Marlon is not rushing in, is not as aggressive as he was.
it was a devastating knockout punch. It just hit him in the ear. And you know, if you get hit there, it hurts.